Welcome to Lattes and Lifting.
Grab a coffee and join us as we chat all about food, fitness, and finding your freedom.
Through this podcast, we will help you navigate the fitness world stress-free.
Hello.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to the pod.
Oh, we're here today.
Hope you're doing well. I hope you've seen some sunshine. I'm having a wine the last couple of days. I asked my partner in the car today. I said, do you think the sun's ever going to come out again? Because I feel like we haven't seen much in the last like week.
Same. I just had that conversation last night. I was leading my mountain bike group ride, which ended in disaster. If you don't follow me on Instagram,
I voted on wear the raincoat. So
yeah, and I didn't, and I got wet. I got really wet and my bike broke. And a really nice participant gave me a ride home, which was really nice of her. And as it's funny, it's the same person who we were riding to the trailhead. It started to drizzle a little bit. And she goes, I'm really sick of the rain, Jess. And I was like, I hear ya.
Yeah.
I hear ya. I was like, we can't really complain because the alternative is that we live in a smoke-filled inferno of a province.
Like we need the rain, yes, but like, do we need it all many days in a row? Could I have like all I'm looking for here is like an hour of sunshine. Just give me one day of like no rain and sun, and then you can go back.
And I'm like, is it possible to get seasonal depression, like seasonal affective disorder, in the summer?
Yeah,
apparently it is, because I am fueled, I'm solar powered.
That's why people say like they're like, I could never make it in Vancouver. And I disagree with that statement because Vancouver has an ocean. And I think that makes everything easier versus here when it's
ocean
gray.
Ocean trumps. Rainy.
Yeah. When it's here in gray, I'm just looking at houses. Like I can go sit in the rain and look at the ocean. And that balances each other out, you know?
Yeah. Yeah.
So you got to be something to say for like the ocean's got to give you a one up over there.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. I've never lived close to the ocean, but I'm sure it's lovely. I mean, The ocean always makes me feel nice, but
that's what I mean. Like, it has to be better than here when it's gray and rainy. So I don't believe I would never make it in Vancouver. No, I think you'd be fine because it's cooler. But
anyway. I think that's not even a matter of opinion, in that Vancouver is better than, like, that's just not at hockey, mind you. see ya later, Canucks.
Like, Oilers. Also, when it rains here, it's cold. Like it's like 3 to 5 degrees in the morning. When it rains in Vancouver, it's still like 15 degrees. So you're not cold and wet, you're just wet.
Yeah.
Anywho, yeah. That's my debate on why Vancouver would actually be doable.
Well, besides the weather, do you have a win for the week?
What have I been up to? I feel like I've been busy but not busy all at the same time. I don't know. It's limbo over here. What's my win? I gotta have something. I don't know. Apparently I don't got much. I think it's been pretty average. I'm trying currently to like hit a goal number with amount of clients I have. That's a little tricky in the summer because like things really ebb and flow in the summer because people go do other things, but we're slowly working towards it. I would say my win is that I have a game plan with my content because I have a manager. We've heard of him. His name's Adam. He's lovely. And every week I'm like, I did this thing. And he's like, cool, do more. So we finally like game planned on our call this week of like, he wants me to post Monday to Friday, like every day on Instagram, 5 days. And that felt stressful. But then I game planned of like what that content actually looks like. And now it feels less overwhelming. So I'm excited to see how next week plays out. It's actually going to be like a Sunday to Thursday type of thing because I post my Sunday thoughts every Sunday. So instead of taking Saturday, Sunday off, I'm going to not post on Friday and Saturday. We're going to see. It's like a half win because I haven't actually like done 5 days in a row of posting, but like we have a game plan to do it. So
that's having a plan is important. I highly recommend if you use Canva for any of your stuff to schedule it in Canva, and it'll just post on its own and you don't have to worry about it.
See, that's my thing is like I'm trying to get away from infographics because he makes a fair point. Like nobody reads anything on social media anymore. So he, yeah, not that like I can't post infographics, but that should be like a once every couple weeks versus like, yeah. So Canva, as helpful as that is, won't be that helpful because I'm not going to use just graphics that often.
Well, you can use just photos on Canva too. I just use it for the scheduler.
Yeah, that is a nice perk.
Yeah.
What's your one?
Gosh, I was thinking of one before we jumped on the call, but now I have no idea. I feel like I've been saying the same thing. Oh, you know what? I do have a win. I have a strength training win.
Okay.
I don't know if I've shared a ton. I've had like this gimpy shoulder thing since like, I don't know, November, December. I haven't pushed it. I haven't really explored it. I just kind of like left it. But it's been 6 weeks of doing a really consistent strength training program that includes like all the shoulder directions. And I pressed overhead today with a 20 pound dumbbell with no pain for 4 sets of 10. So, whatever was going on has left the building because now we can start pushing some actual weight. I know that sounds really like for a lot of people, 20 pounds is a lot. But for me, it's not a lot compared to what I'm used to. So, also speaking of that, I really liked your video that you had that was like intimidated by this overhead press, do this. I thought it was really cool. I was like, okay. Oh, that's cute.
It's some of my like favorite content I've been making. And that's part of like the content plan is to have like a mix of like workouts and then a nutrition post and then a holistic post and then, like a lifestyle post. Cause like I forget that I do a lot within my business and sometimes I get stuck on like one thing. Yeah. And that's all I post about. So, but those have been fun. Cause like, I know the gym is intimidating for a lot of people. So being able to like break it down and be like, if this is your goal, start here, has been fun for me. And yeah. I have like a really long list in my phone of like all the exercises you can do that with. So if you ever think of any, feel free to send them my way. But
well, and those are like so good because I feel like it's lovely for people to have a coach. We love people who have coaches, right? Obviously there are clients, but a lot of people don't. And it's cool. Like we're not going to pressure you into getting a coach, but at the same time, you might be stuck doing the same exercises over and over again because you don't know how to progress or you're afraid. And to have a little tidbit where you're like, oh, I could do that. That's helpful, right?
Thanks. So yeah. I'm trying to put out content that's like helpful with like no pressure, if that makes sense. Of like, here is literally just a helpful piece of content. And if you need more help, I got you. If this is all you needed, cool. They're not my like posts that like gain the most traction, but there's always at least a couple comments on TikTok and Instagram of people being like, this was really helpful. So like that will always be important to me, that it's like actually useful for people.
And I think we forget that a lot of times people will still go to Instagram and TikTok for workout ideas or for things like that. And that's not going to stop. But what we can stop is them getting BS information.
Yeah. And like, I'm not going to post a whole workout for you because then you don't need to pay for my coaching, but like, I'll help you work through a movement or two.
But speaking of going for stuff on the internet, man, you guys, we have a good one today. This kind of started because I kept seeing this person come up who's talking about cycle syncing. So we thought we'd talk about timings of different things and how they can be beneficial or not.
Cycle syncing has been floating around the internet for like a quick minute. Like, I'm not gonna lie to you, I fully thought it was gonna die off by now. It hasn't. It's still a big,
I think it's come and gone again.
But like, people really just like are beating a dead horse. Like, I'm like, haven't we already done this? I'm confused. So if you didn't know, there is like there is ways you can match your workouts to your menstrual cycle. And if you're listening, being like, what do you mean cycle syncing? We're talking about your menstrual cycle. Is it necessary? Short answer, no. Could you do it? Sure, if you want to. It's probably not going to make that big of a difference, though. So like the breakdown of cycle syncing, we'll go through that first, and then whether we think it's actually helpful or not. There is certain things you can line up with the days of your cycle that are supposedly supposed to be more beneficial, allow you to see more progress, match with your hormone levels, allow you to feel better in your cycle, all these things. Personally, I'm not changing my training program for where I'm at in my cycle. Like, I have goals to hit and shit to get done. And like, yeah, whatever, being a woman comes with having a menstrual cycle most of the time. But like, that feels like far too much brain power to be like, oh, what day am I on? Okay, this is the workout I have to do. Mm-hmm. But if you were to set it up that way during your menstrual phase, so day one of your period is when you start bleeding, which whenever I say that to people, they're like, really? If you didn't know, that's how you're supposed to track your cycle. Day one is the first day of your bleed. So you would go day one until your period ends. And in those like 3 to 7 days, you would want to be focusing on like lower intensity things, walking, stretching, yoga, whatever. I'm not stretching for 7 days straight, but that would be ideal, in air quotes, if you're not watching on YouTube. Then you have your follicular phase. So they do it by season sometimes, and that hurts my brain. So we're not going to get into that. But that would be like day 7 to 10-ish. And you're still pretty low impact. So you're going like swimming, running, or cardio, power, yoga, more intense things, like stuff like that. We still haven't touched strength training. So that's 2 weeks-ish, no weights. Then when you ovulate, that's when you would, which is only 2 to 4 days, you would want to focus on like CrossFit or HIIT training or cycling or cardio for like 2 to 4 days. And then your luteal phase is when you would strength train, low incline walking, yoga, bar, that kind of stuff. So if you follow cycle syncing, you're really only strength training for a total of 6 to 8 days a month, and the rest would be lower impact. And then you would start all over again. You can do that if you want, but I think I would actually go insane mentally if I only strength trained for a third of every month.
Yeah. It seemed like a lot of effort for a problem. Is it? I don't know. The thing is like, do you even have a problem before we start mucking around with something this complicated? So my stance is always adjust how you feel on the day. Yep. So because here's the thing, the way that I feel on day 5 isn't the way that Jill feels on her day 5. Probably it would be a big coincidence if we did. Nobody's cycles are exactly, nobody's symptoms or whatever is going on is exactly the same. Mm-hmm. So I am always a cheerleader for whatever you have on the day, adjust accordingly. So if you feel like on when you're, I don't know, one of the ones where you're supposed to be doing power yoga, if you feel like you can go and hit a PR in your squats, do it. Right. If that's obviously, if that's what's on the calendar. But I'm also of the age group that women were still using their periods to get out of gym class. And that's what cycle syncing gives me the ick about, is it sounds like I'm on my period, I can't play volleyball. That's what it's giving me. And I'm sorry if that feels icky, but it makes me feel icky to be like, no, like you can do anything you want to do any time of the month. And the other part of this is, let's say you're somebody who's, I don't know, a power lifter. Okay. Because cycle syncing doesn't really lend itself to weightlifting, mm-hmm. right? Let's be honest. That's another F the patriarchy thing. I think it's a ploy to get women to stop lifting weights, but whatever. If you're, let's say, a power lifter, what happens in the very likely event that your competition falls on a day when you ain't supposed to be lifting heavy? What do you do? Right? Sorry, guys. I can't.
And that's what I was going to say is, like, it makes it really hard to follow a structured program. It's probably also going to make it really hard to see progress, because if you can only strength train for a week-ish every single month, you're not seeing very many strength gains. So you're maybe doing 4 to 6 workouts of strength a month, if we look at it that way. So if you're looking to see progress in the gym, or you're looking to train for competition or powerlifting or learn how to do a pull-up, like, that progress is going to take you forever / never happen, because you just don't have enough days to touch the weights and touch the movements you need to.
Yeah. And from a scientific research perspective, the research does not lend itself to be cycle syncing friendly. In a short, quick sentence, the research does not back it up. The research backs up what we're saying, which is adjust as per the day and as per the symptoms you may or may not be dealing with on that day.
Mm-hmm. I think this might be a hot take, but cycle syncing, as you kind of said, gives us a convenient excuse to be like, well,
yeah,
do the thing. And I think a lot, like, yes, there's a lot of people that have a menstrual cycle that have symptoms, and you have a bad time, and a couple days out of the month you're like down and out. Cool, listen to that, but don't be like, oh, I feel fine, but according to the internet I'm supposed to do yoga today, so I guess I'm doing yoga today. Like, if you need a break, take a break. There's a couple days during my cycle where I don't love to work out, or maybe I just need to sleep in a little bit extra. Like, there's probably other adjustments you can make that will allow you to do what you need to do in the gym without just having to be like, oh, can't do it because of X, Y, and Z. Like, take a nap.
Yeah.
Sleep in a little bit. Drink an extra cup of coffee. I don't know. Figure it out with love.
Yeah, 100%. And I think that it all is going to boil down to just using your cycle to learn more about your body and your preferences and the way that your body works, right? I don't think our cycle is not there to work against us as much as sometimes we feel that it is going against what we want to do. But you can make minor adjustments on the day. And that's really what any kind of training, strength or endurance wise, is all about, is learning about your body, your tendencies, your likes, your dislikes, your, you know, like, maybe, like, you know, there's all that whole, like, never miss a Monday, but maybe Monday is a great rest day for you, right? Like, it's just learning those things and being like, oh yeah, like, this is what my body prefers in this state. Because to have a broad blanket thrown over it that, like, everybody in their follicular is going to be needing to do this doesn't make a heck of a lot of sense to people like Jill and I, who think of people as individuals no matter what's going on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I think everyone feels different within their cycle too. Like, I actually really like to work out the first couple days of my cycle because I feel strong. Even if, like, I might be a little bit tired, like, if I can get myself in the gym and do the thing, it's usually mm-hmm. a really good lift. But if I didn't experiment and figure that out, I probably wouldn't know that. So it's just playing with that.
And the other part of it is, let's think about the mental load that keeping all that in mind does to somebody, right? Because if you're somebody who has a lot of other stuff on their plate, like, let's say you're a parent and you also have some pelvic floor symptoms that come up with different parts of your cycle, now we have to think about all that too. And honestly, it just seems like a lot. It doesn't have to be that difficult. Why it is becoming that difficult, I don't know. Like I said, I think that it is all just a F the patriarchy thing. And, you know, like, somebody who thought up with cycle syncing was probably a dude. Let's be honest.
Totally. Yeah, I think it depends how much, 100%, how much mental load you have. Like, I do not give a fuck enough to pay that much attention. Like, I have to keep tabs on enough things in my life. I don't also need to be like, oh, it's day 8. Okay, yoga today. Oh, now it's day 10. Okay, I can go lift weights. Like, I'm not. No.
Give yourself permission to go lift weights because yeah, you're like,
no, no. Just a no from me. But, like, I've seen many coaches talk about it, and I think all the good coaches have similar opinions of, like, sure, do it if you want. But if it's going to stress you out and not be like, and you're not going to be able to get to where you want to be with your workouts, then, like, it's not for you. It might be for some people. It's definitely not for me. But, like, you make that decision on your own. And there's lots of coaches that will happily help you do that. But it ain't us.
Yeah. Yeah. Honestly, if you came to me and were like, yeah, I want my workouts to be cycle synced, I'd be like, I'm not the coach for you.
Yeah, which is fair. Speaking of timing, we also saw a post that was talking about the timing of cardio, which has always
been I just read the text on the, I sent you a screenshot from TikTok, and this person is a trainer. So, okay. It says, maturing in the gym is realizing doing cardio after lifting will burn more fat because it forces your body to burn the fat for fuel. Train smarter with a progressive overload plan, not harder.
Okay, so before we even talk about cardio timing, those two have nothing to do with each other. A progressive overload program. You're right. Train smarter with a program that has progressive overload. What the fuck?
We'll give you that. We'll give you that.
Like, what the fuck does that have to do with when I do my cardio? I don't understand. How do those two things go together?
Yeah. And before we, like, get into maturing in the gym, whatever that means, I know it's just a tagline that people use to get views and whatever, but can we talk about physiology for a second and energy systems? Because I don't think that, I didn't catch her name. Sorry, ma'am. I don't think she understands how they work. Your body has a source of fuel for energy, and that source of fuel is not fat. Not even a little.
Called glucose, which is also known as
sugar, carbohydrates. I know it's like trendy to be like, get your body to burn fat instead of whatever else, but there's nothing else. That's the thing. Is,
well, we also said before we started recording, like, we get what she's trying to say, and there is a little bit of science behind the timing of your cardio, but it's not that. Like you said before, I'll say what I said first. Like, if your body's going to burn the fastest store first, which is going to be the food you ate before you got to the gym. So Usually you want to save that, or I would like to save that for strength training, for lifting weights, things like that, because I'm going to have the most readily available energy source to lift heavy. And that is always my focus. Then when I'm done, I'll go on the treadmill and get some steps in if I want to, because I'm not trying to PR my incline walk on the treadmill. So I don't need those immediate stores to do what I need to do. So there is a little bit of science there, but it's not the science she's trying to talk about.
And then what I said was, in the eternal debate of do we lift or do cardio first, it is whichever your priority is first. So if you're a runner and you have like a 5K to do, and then you have some strength training to do, you're going to do your run first. Mm-hmm. And if you are a lifter with some cardio goals, you're going to do your lifting first, because lifting is your priority. Or you're going to do whatever works. And if you're going to do that long of a workout, honestly, have some fuel. And I've been having conversations like this with a lot of my endurance athletes, because it's race season. We're talking about fueling. This is why when you are doing like a longer race, you have things like gels and carb drinks. And the most important part of those things is carbs. Mm-hmm. So I had a conversation with a client who was like, yeah, I just take water and these like gummy chews for like a 2-hour run. And I was like, cool. We did the math. She would need to eat 5 packages of these things to get enough carbs, because your body needs like 40 to 60 grams of carbs per hour of output, which is why when you're done your workout, you need to replenish carbs and protein.
That's why I eat a pre-workout bowl of cereal.
Notice how I didn't say anything about fat.
Yeah.
Because we didn't use those stores. And this is also like, this is kind of going into the realm of like, there are, I'm like, this is a group over here, an outlier group of keto endurance people who think that they can use their fat stores for endurance sport. That's not how your energy system works.
Like, it might work that way eventually, but you know how many other things your body's going to burn through first?
Like, we're not even going to talk about those people, but that's, I think that's where this idea comes from, that we can teach our bodies to use fat instead of carbs. The thing is, you could, but why would you want to?
Well, it's the same when there used to be a debate with fasted cardio too. Like, oh, go do fasted cardio in the morning because then you burn fat instead of carbs. Like,
it's the same thing.
Hurts.
The only thing you're doing, the only thing you're doing is you're depleting your body's glycogen stores, which is why endurance athletes have to take in carbs when they're exercising, because we have this number of like reserves based on what you've eaten like yesterday and right before, even a couple of days before, if we're talking about carb loading and stuff. But once that's gone, we can't replace it with fat. We need to replace it with more carbs. Carbs. I'm just going to keep saying carbs until people get it, because that is what your body's energy, that is the most efficient form of fuel. It's like putting premium gasoline in a high performance engine.
Yeah, and it's the same, like, we could turn this into any argument. It's why keto is really hard for people to maintain, because it takes 3 to 4 days to enter ketosis.
And we've talked about this before. We have a whole episode on keto.
So if we're making the argument of burning fat, you got to work out for a real long time to get your body to
burn. Or not have any carb input so that you don't have those glycogen stores to get into ketosis and then train your body how to use fat, which seems, it's, the thing is, it's not efficient.
No,
it's not efficient. Your body
is going to take a hit.
Yeah. Your body is already efficient. Like, this is hundreds and hundreds of years of evolution and cellular development. This is not new information. Like, you can't, physiology doesn't lie. Like, that's the whole episode. Physiology doesn't lie. Like, this is physiology 101. Go to a university, take a class, and then try to tell me that you're right on your, and it just the irony of her being on the stair stepper is just like icing on the cake, because that's those kind of, not, no offense to the stair steppers, but like, those are the kind of people that are making claims like this. They're on the
stair. Tried really hard for a long time to be like, I can be a girl who goes on the stair climber, and then I'd make it 5 minutes and be like, I want to off myself. So we stopped trying to do that. It's hard.
You know, hard, do you know what time. Would do you know what would boost your mood on the Stairmaster?
What?
Carbs.
Maybe if I had a little snickety snack, I'll try again. Just like stand there eating some candy while I step on the stairs. Yeah, I think the overall theme is just like all of
this. Carbs are not the enemy. Your period is not the enemy.
And like all of this adds to your mental load, and we got enough
shit. That's the episode.
Like, we got enough shit going on that we don't also need to be like, well, have I burned through all my carbs and am I on the proper day of my cycle? Like, no, just go to the gym, do your workout.
Oh my God. Could you imagine? There's probably a cycle syncing diet. Like, who are we kidding? Mm-hmm. If you've seen it, let us know. Because,
and like, don't get me wrong,
I'd like to read that.
shameless plug, there's plenty of things we can change with nutrition and supplements to make our cycles more manageable, anti-inflammatory. You know, I won't get into it today, but like, if we're going to care about our cycle, let's do it through nutrition and supplements, not when we lift weights and when we don't.
Lifting weights is something that doesn't need to be synced to anything. You should lift weights more often than you don't.
Yeah.
Endurance athletes included.
And yeah, don't stress about it. Do your thing. Adjust on the day, adjust on the fly, adjust when you feel like garbage. But don't let the internet tell you when you can and can't do things. You get to make those decisions yourself. And if you're like, yeah, everything's stressful, I'm overwhelmed, I don't know what I'm doing, we would love to help you out. As always, you can send us a DM on the podcast page at Lattes and Lifting Podcast. If you don't know which one to go to first, send a DM there. I manage our Instagram, so I'll point you in the right direction. And as always, you can find me at coachjill.april on TikTok and Instagram.
And you can find me at JLock Fitness.
And we will, as always, catch you guys next time.
Bye.